Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to be talking about one of my favorite motorcycle manufacturer, and he is one of the most famous motorcycle manufacturer in India and all over the globe as well. I'm 100% sure that you know this manufacturer, and it is known as the Royal Enfield Motorcycles. And I'm going to be talking about how it started and how is the company doing in present condition. So let's get started with the video. Now, whenever you start a company, it is not at all like the first release will be the one which you want to get it. So when this company was started in 1892, they were actually not producing motorcycles or even cycles, that to matter. They were actually producing bullets. Not the bike bullet, but they were actually producing the bullets which were used in guns and armories. And they had a factory for manufacturing guns and bullets, so they actually started their journey as an armed force manufacturer. Then in 1896 they started manufacturing cycles, and they took off as a cycle company, and they named that company as Enfield Cycle Limited. Because of their success on selling the cycles, they started producing motorcycles. Not the motorcycle which you see in present condition. They took the whole cycle and they just put on a motor. So they combined it both, calling it as the motorcycle. That's it. And in 1901 they started producing motorcycles, and because of their success in producing motorcycles as well, they stepped into the four-wheel industry. And this company was not at all good at multitasking, and immediately in 1907 they sold this four-wheel company to a company called Alldays, and they were in a pretty huge loss. That's the reason they didn't sell any more four-wheelers and they sold that company to Alldays. Now every company needs a breakthrough, and even not only Royal Enfield, you can take any example, even any individual or even a company, everyone needs a breakthrough. And Royal Enfield got this breakthrough when the world war started, and Britishers called this company for their motorcycles for their British armed forces. Royal Enfield started producing some 425cc V-twin engines which were manufactured especially for the British army. And after looking at these motorcycles, Russia was like, even I want those motorcycles, why only Britishers, why only UK, even Russia needs that. So Russia immediately called up and asked for the Royal Enfield motorcycles for their armed forces too. Then the Royal Enfield name came into existence and they became a huge thing in the world as a motorcycle manufacturer. So their success story started actually from 1914 when they started producing their motorcycles for the British Armed Force and Russian Armed Force, and when these motorcycles were used in the World War. Now if your motorcycles are good, you will prefer to buy the same company manufactured products over and over again, right? So that's the reason why British Armed Forces started buying these motorcycles in the Second World War II, because of their build quality and ruggedness, and people were taking it anywhere they want. They were taking it to climb the mountains, they were taking it to floods, they were taking it to river crossing, anywhere. So they were pretty rugged, so that's the reason why British Armed Forces actually opted these company motorcycles for their British Armed Forces. And all because of this success, British launched their Royal Enfield brand in 1949 and started producing motorcycles in India also. They started their company in India by collaborating with Madras Motors, and initially they were not at all successful, because I don't know why. The motorcycles were good, but as India got freedom in that period only, and the name Britishers Motorcycle Company, maybe that's the reason why it got a pretty low concentration on them or a pretty low attention for them in the initial stage. But when these motorcycles were used in the Indian Army and the Indian Police, these motorcycles became suddenly famous. They were producing the same motorcycles and people were not interested in buying those, and Royal Enfield was bankrupt. Since they were importing all the products from UK and assembling it in India, there were no huge amount of profits that Royal Enfield was getting from the sales, so they closed the manufacturing in the UK. Though in Indian sales they were getting a huge amount of loss, still they were producing the motorcycles in India, but at some point they gave up and they closed the company. And at this point a huge a Royal Enfield fan, or I don't know who it is, the owner or the CEO of HR Commercial Vehicles bought this company in 1990, and he started the manufacturing once again, and he redesigned this motorcycles and made it a bit of a modern motorcycle with same look as the retro look, and started manufacturing in the Madras motorway. Now the sales of these motorcycles started to increase in the early 2000s, and these motorcycles were becoming more and more common as they produced the motorcycles in the name of Bullet, Electra, Thunderbolt, and all these motorcycles became pretty famous in India, and they started once again to grow up in worldwide condition as well. And when they launched their Classic 350 and Classic 500 and Himalayan models in early 2010s, the sales grew up rapidly. They were almost like they were selling like a Honda's Activa, so the sales grew up pretty heavily, and because of this they started manufacturing more and more motorcycles, and they gained more and more profit. And because of all this success what they gained because of their sales, they bought a company called Harris Performance Limited, which is based on a UK company, but they bought this company from the UK, and these are the people who designed the Continental GT 650 and the Interceptor 650, which is currently selling in India. And the price, man, the base Interceptor 650 comes at 3 lakhs in Bangalore. So a 650 twin with a 270 degree crank angle, wow, the price is amazing. That's the reason why Royal Enfield got so much of success in India, and now they are selling over 50 countries worldwide, including America, Australia, India, and so many other countries as well, and they are pretty successful now. Every company will have one or the other model which is the most loved model of that company from their customers, and Royal Enfield is pretty famous for their classic lineup in the name of Classic 350 and the Classic 500. So what does the history of Royal Enfield, how they started and how they grew up. Hope Royal Enfield will improve a lot in terms of technology and in terms of everything, in terms of sales as well. And let's hope their future motorcycle will be as good as their motorcycle were in the past and at the present as well. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe, and that's all with this video, guys. Peace.